drive along any country road during growing season, and you'll not only see the hard work of Nebraska farmers, but also the work of people like Charlie Fenster. Now in his mid-90s and busy as ever, Charlie still enjoys doing what he's done all his life, watching the crops.
Well, I think the thing that really stood out for me was the dirty 30s, the Dust Bowl years.
Raised on a farm outside of Chapel, Charlie was 10 years old when the severe dust storms wreaked havoc on the American plains. His dad was a dryland farmer, and wheat, the family cash crop. It was the combination of these three things that set Charlie on a path he'd follow throughout his life.
At that time, the university had what they called a farmer operator short course, and it was a short version of the various crops and livestock that could be used on the farm.
Charlie graduated from the University of Nebraska with a four-year degree in vocational agriculture in 1942. He was teaching and pursuing his master's when he was offered a new job in a groundbreaking field of work.
I was working there in this local conservation office, and the state people, state conservationists came in, and he says, "We'd like to have people like you work for us."
And so, Charlie left his desk job for a position with the Soil Conservation Service, where he began his research on dryland farming. With cooperation from area farmers, research was done on privately held land. Then, in 1955, as the USDA was reorganizing, Charlie had to make a choice between being either a full-time conservationist or a researcher.
The Soil Conservation Service came up and said, "The university wants to hire you to work on the sandy land erosion problems in western Nebraska."
Charlie went to work for the University of Nebraska, where he could continue his efforts in both research and conservation. Living back in the panhandle, he studied winter erosion, how to make crops grow, and wheat.
We decided to set up a diesel planting on various places there in the panhandle, and the end result was we found that elevation had a lot to do with the length of growing season. It took us quite a while to figure that out. It pointed out to us there was a real difference in the environment with different locations. So we finally tied it to elevation, and it's still used today.
The results of this research is the steady rise in wheat yield per acre from 11 bushels in 1956 to over 40 today. Charlie's also been at the forefront of developing no-till farming, even assisting in the design of new equipment. And Charlie's work hasn't just benefited Nebraska farmers, but farmers across the world. So, when the University of Nebraska told Charlie they wanted to name a new research facility after him, he had only one thing to say.
"As I told the chancellor, I said, if this enhances dryland research and extension work in western Nebraska, go for it. Otherwise, don't you do it." That was the very words I used to it.
How could anyone argue with Charlie? Not that anyone wanted to.
When I started out with the university, they told me right to begin with, "You are going to be on a joint appointment, both research and extension." And I think that's the way it ought to be. The new building is to enhance the facilities to get people to come out here and work on critical problems throughout the year. Graduate students, it's a real good place to send them up. That's a tremendous asset for their development.
Charlie Fenster, the farmer's son who grew up to make the world a little bit better for all of us.